involving suicide.
I will say I do like his version. Not better than this one, of course.
I like it, but like people like don't know that it's like a remake of the song. So
really,
I sure did.
Yeah, like when it dropped, I was like, yeah. Like I remember we had this conversation with Josh where he's like, oh, I didn't know this was a.
Oh yeah, we did. Yeah, a remake,
a different song. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it makes me laugh. I'm just like, yeah, do y'all not know System of a Down? Like, the original was so much better. I mean, yeah, it sucks that band is no longer a band no more.
I know Syndrome of a Down.
Are they not a band? Or
they broke up a while ago. A while ago. Like, I just, you know, band disputes over stupid shit. You know?
I haven't been keeping up with my SOD news.
Yeah, it's... I think in the early 2000s they broke
up.
I'm sure.
Before we started, we were talking about
killing turkeys,
but Mexican food in the DFW area.
Yeah,
y'all see the Oak Cliff Trumpopo.
The Trumpo, yeah, like they were gonna, they were
El Trumpo.
They lost a restaurant, did a GoFundMe, and then got it back.
Got it back or something.
Yeah.
But I saw people kind of like, I guess, hating in the comments, being like, what'd y'all do to like fuck up like this?
So, what'd they do?
I don't know. They never addressed it. They got the money they needed. Raised $30,000+.
That's crazy. I wish people could donate to me $37,000.
Hey, yeah. Spread the word.
Never had the place. I've heard it's good. It's always highly rated.
But. Yeah. I saw all over Instagram and I was like, oh, man. Like, he had a live that was like 10 minutes long. I'm like, I'm not watching all this, bro.
No. Y'all remember when, like, the baby was found in the dumpster at Eddie Max?
Yeah.
That didn't get shut down. They were just like, all right, go about your day.
I think it did get shut down for a little bit.
Yeah.
Well, but it was back.
I remember...
not anymore, though.
Going to Subway in Sherman, and this, like, just ogre of a lady was in front of me. And she was ordering two sandwiches.
Both
and
for
was
her.
Just, like, talking to the... I'm not going to make that assumption. Maybe she had family back home.
And now she's an ogre.
But was just talking to the, like, Subway guy or whatever.
Sandwich artist.
Who hates his job.
But he seemed like he was having a good day. But I don't remember what they were talking about. They started talking about burgers. And he was like, you know whose burgers I actually really like? Wendy's.
What the?
Like, Wendy's, just that square burger, it just works for me. I don't know. And this lady was like, oh, I don't do any fast food burgers. Where I Eddie Mac's. That's my like family's restaurant. Like we own it. All of our burgers are fresh and stuff. Like made every day.
From babies?
And then he was like, oh, that's that place that the baby got found in the dumpster. She was like, well, we don't talk about that.
We don't talk. Well, I'm talking about
it. I bet you don't. Yeah. Everyone else does.
Yeah. I never had Eddie Mac's.
It used to be pretty good.
It's now not open, but.
It's Magic City.
Magic Smoke.
Yeah. It's Magic Smoke.
Which I've heard is very good.
I heard really good things about them.
Any babies the found homie, in the dumpster?
The homie Daniel would send me Snapchats every time he would go there and be like, dude, check this out.
Oh, you said
fire.
Yeah. Damn. Yeah, I always want to get it, and then I forget me and my girl always talking about, let's go to restaurants we haven't been to Sherman. And it's that one, Krakonoink as well.
Oh, I love Krakonoink, but go, if for whatever reason, if you're in Sherman on St. Paddy's Day, they do a corned beef every year, only on St. Paddy's Day, and it's fucking fire.
And Krakonoink?
Yep, corned beef with... the stewed cabbage.
Yeah, I went to that Walk Express on Parkway.
Yeah, it's good.
That's good. It's affordable too.
Yeah,
it's a bunch of food.
Yeah, I would say it's like a cheaper Panda. Yeah. Like way more options and way more food.
If I'm in Sherman though, I really only like go out to places like that I haven't had in like long ass time.
Yeah, not gonna like you.
Italian Affair.
Fire.
Teriyaki Jar.
Fire.
I've never eaten there.
Oh, I love good. Teriyaki Jar.
It's really good. I haven't been there. I'm going to take my girl. I don't think she's ever had teriyaki
jar. They got a chicken katsu, but I used to like live off their wonton soup.
Pupuseria.
Pupuseria is good.
I've never been to the Pupuseria. The only time I get pupusas is, what's that restaurant called? Oh, I'm good on that. The one by the hospital.
Yeah, Rex. That's what. Right in front of the hospital?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what we're talking about.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh, it's not called Pupusa.
Yeah, I know. My mom calls it that, yeah. Which just makes me laugh. So.
Damn, now...
La Placita.
Right? La Placita, yeah. There's another one down by, like, down the street further down in front of the Jazz Museum. And I've never been there either because I'm just like, y'all too much Salvador pride over here. There's a little Salvies. Tres veces mojados.
I think I know which one you're talking about. Like, kind of about the old high school.
No, that's Chef Angel.
Oh.
That's actually really good, I heard. I have not had it either, but I heard it's really good.
No, you're talking about, like, kind of, like, downtown Sherman.
Yeah, area. Like, in front of the Jazz Museum. Yeah. Like, right there.
El Camino. Or Camino Viejo.
No, that's the opposite side. The other one way that goes down.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. Like you would see it if you were, like, driving.
Corner of Juana and...
It's like a place you drive by and you're like, oh, I didn't even know that's, like, a open business.
Yeah, like, if you drive down just on the right-hand side of downtown passing, like, the opposite side of... I always forget. Lamar, is it?
No.
Yeah.
Couldn't tell you.
Yeah, I think it's Lamar that goes down. Houston's the one that goes down the opposite way, like towards
my crib. Yeah, you went from like where my parents used to live.
Going down, okay. So it's Houston and Walnut. That's in the corner on the right hand side.
Is the Jazz Museum like by the Church's Chicken?
Yeah, just down the block, and then there, and then in front of that is that Salvadorian restaurant. Used to be a church.
There's like a painting of a fish and shit on the outside.
Yeah, it used to be a church. Yeah, it's a very
Pescado.
Yeah, but
Correctamundo.
Correct. I
was looking at the TV guide last night. Maybe it's just a like shitty time to look. It's on a Friday. There is not any like hour long programming with congruent with
congruent.
Yes, with fucking late night TV shows. On Latin programming. It's like ads.
Really? What? Yeah.
Telemundo and whatever the other one is.
There's
Univision.
Yeah, Univision and Telemundo are the big ones here. That's weird because they... Oh, well. Because the big one back then was Sábado Gigante.
Yeah.
We talked about that on the pod. Like
one of them had some show. I meant to like Snapchat it to you, but one of them had some show that was like with like late night. Like late night.
Yeah.
Like after the Tonight Show.
Okay.
But like same time as Tonight Show was just paid programming.
I wonder what show it is. Yeah. I mean, then you got plenty of Hispanic channel or Mexican channels, Spanish channels, I guess. You got Univision, Telemundo are the big ones. Then you got Galivision, Azteca TV. There's a one with the eye. I forget what's it called. And these are more like you have to have like satellite to get it. And then, but the broadcast is because Telemundo and Univision have offices down here.
Yeah. So I didn't get the Latin package.
Yeah.
But I believe YouTube TV has.
Yeah. I mean, nowadays you can just stream everything. So, and now a lot of things.
I stream it all the time.
The Sábado Gigante?
Every day.
Don Francisco?
Don't miss an episode.
I wake up, turn it on. I know that.
Yeah. That's something we should definitely add now thinking about it. The trumpet I'm talking about. I'll show you later and I'll show you what I'm talking about. Because it's literally how the Apollo Theater has the cane.
Yep.
Same thing.
Okay.
Yeah, but it's just with the guy and the bugle, that's wearing an executioner outfit. And they're just he just comes in like, nah, you trash, get out. It's funny as shit. Because people go in there, they talk about their story in the beginning, like, oh, this is my dream. Yeah. I can't believe I'm all here. And they're trash, like, nah, get out. Boo. But yeah. But back to the Mexican food. Mexican sugar is good. I have to buy two meals to get full.
Oh.
I couldn't tell you what I got.
But then again, I'm a big dude.
Yeah.
Two meals gave me like.
I'm not slight of frame.
Yeah. But like two meals gave me like pause. Stuff.
I think the best over by you though is that Revolver pop up if it's still there. Like in the AT&T.
Oh, never eaten there.
I heard great things. I haven't had Revolver either.
That's not the main one. The main one's in Deep Ellum.
Yeah.
Which, is, I mean, it also isn't.
It's a. They have their
the
own
old bar. Enchiladas that was there before it closed was fire.
Yeah. I mean, I'm pretty sure that's the OG location.
It is. It's the
one down the street.
Excuse me.
So nothing's even gone in there. Like, there's so many places that closed over there, like Iron Cactus.
Yeah.
Yeah. Dallas I forgot Fish about Market. Iron Cactus.
I never ate at that one, but I would.
I like their burgers.
I ate there on my 21st birthday.
I had Iron Cactus.
One of my last memories that night.
That night. And after I stepped outside that building.
And I was at a Mavericks game for a bit. And then I was at Lower Greenville for a minute. And then I woke up.
And then you woke up like, where am I? Oh, okay.
At the hotel.
Yeah.
And we made it.
Yeah. This is the best is after a night of like debauchery, you get home. And then like, let's say you black out and you wake up, you're like. Okay.
I there?
I think so.
I don't
know. We went to like Old Crow.
I would assume since it was Lower Greenville. Yeah. But.
We didn't do, I don't think we went to Single Wide that night though, but because you would have been living in Allen at the time. Because I was turning 21.
No. I would have been in Sherman.
Oh, well, I'm sure you would have come either way if you were that close.
Maybe.
But I don't know.
Couldn't tell you.
Again, either. I blacked out.
So. Yeah, so I can't tell you either. That's funny. Oh, man. That's hilarious. I remember one time you were with us and you blacked out. You just ran away.
I'm talking about your Batman.
Yeah, you just ran away from us.
I mean, who would know?
I was like,
not me again, because I blacked out.
Like, where's Matt? Just, dude, I'm Batman. Oh, man. I was like, damn, this man parties hard. Blacked out already.
Well, I used to never eat before. I can still get pretty drunk, don't get me wrong, but I used to, just never eat. And then,
That's a life hack. If you're young, don't have money, and you want to get lit, wasted fast.
Just go to Taco Bell first. You can spend $4
diarrhea the next day.
Well, hey, diarrhea is better than becoming Batman, I can assure you.
Oh, man. Anytime I eat Taco Bell, I just tell myself, hey, man, tomorrow's going to be a rough day.
Hey.
Like at work, people see me like, man, you've been going to a restaurant while I had Taco Bell the other night. They're like, ah. Everyone's like, ah, okay, I get you. I told my supervisor once, hey, I'm taking a half day today. He goes, why? And I'm like, yeah, I've been in and out the bathroom, but, you know, I just blew it up, and I feel so bad for everybody else to go in there. He goes, oh, no, no, you're good, man, you're good. I'm like, all right, man. You know, I bet you on the way to the... I started just going into more detail about it. He's just like, just because I knew it was funny, because he does... Like, that, I could tell that made him uncomfortable. Like, oh, I'm digging into this. Yeah. Like, he's like, oh, yeah, just... get, hey, man, have a good night. And I was like, all right. It's funny.
It'll get you.
Shit.
But, yeah, don't pretend. Like, the thing is, I wasn't really pretending. It was the whole other... The alcohol was just...
Your alter ego? You were Bruce Wayne?
Well, I don't know what I was.
Again, I believe you were asking the Uber driver if he knew Batman.
Well, he did that night.
I'm here. This is me.
I don't tell everyone this.
But I believe it was like phrased, do you know the Batman?
Well, yeah. I mean, sometimes he goes by the Batman, the Dark Knight. You know, there's different titles and phrases, but, you know...
Yeah, I remember one time I was in the clubs in Deep Ellum. Because, you know, people just, you know, nowadays, now everyone just comes in, people just come in costumes regularly, randomly.
Yeah.
Like, random tangent, but, like, I was in, like, Knox Henderson, and it was middle of July, hot as shit, and Santa Claus
showed up. I was going to bring that up, too. I don't know if that was the same story.
Yeah, that's a different one.
But I was there with you.
Say, I showed up as Batman, and I was blacked out.
Yeah. But... Back to the other one, Deep Ellum, Batman showed up with Pikachu. And I was like, what the? And like, I was like, Batman? Pikachu? Like, what the hell is this?
It happened.
And then, like, they were getting twerked on. And then, like, I'm like, how'd you get in with your mask? Like, don't they check your ID and shit? Like, just let you in with, like, a full Batman mask?
How'd you get in without a mask? Like, yeah. COVID's a thing.
No, it's not. The Ukrainian
not
stuff.
Not anymore.
That was good. Shit.
Ukrainian stuff, that one.
Shout out Kurt Metzger.
Yeah. But I would say, if you want to go somewhere, back to the food thing, if you want to go somewhere that's nice, like even nicer than the Mexican Sugar, with Mexican food a little bit more expensive, is Tedesel, which is right across Happiest Hour, I think. Like, I think, like, they share the parking lot. Yeah. It's like, we're Happiest Hour, and then literally right next to us, TSL. They have a club upstairs. Yeah, so
I will stay downstairs then.
Yeah, it's like a club, and then we went to the club. We went because a homie of mine bought a section. And then when they found that we got, like, I'm like, hey, just to let y'all know, I see the line outside, but we got a section upstairs. Like, do we have to wait in the line? And like, oh, you got a section? Oh, and it was like, oh, okay, you're good. Like, no, just whenever you're ready and you pay your tab, our server's going to take you to the front, and then you're just going to walk up.
Yeah.
And I'm like, cool. It's literally what happened. We just, like, got done, server took us, and then it was like, all right, we went up to the section. Small-ass section, by the way. I didn't pay for it. Homies bought it, and I just said, like, I phrased that, like, we got the section. Like, no, the homie's already there. And it was lit. Hella bottles. Sections are where it's at if you have the money.
How much was the section? Do you know?
I didn't ask them, but it's probably like $1,000 or something like that. Yeah. But there's places now where you can get, like, the cheapest section I saw was like, that's bang for your buck. There's a, I don't know if they still do it, but, you know, I'm not going to shout them out, but there's this club in Dallas by Lower Greenville that you can get a big section for $450, and it comes with 3 bottles.
Damn.
Usually, like, a section comes with 1 bottle for like $600-$700. So you get a vodka, a whiskey, and a champagne. They always give you the champagne bottle.
Damn.
No one drinks the champagne. I'm not a champagne drinker. Not my champagne. I don't like that stuff.
I don't mind it.
I just don't like the taste. That's why I've never been into mimosas. Not my thing. I'd rather just drink a whiskey, a Coke at 10:09 in the morning like a real man. Huh. Yeah.
Whatever that works for you.
I remember one time I went for brunch and someone, it's like they all ordered mimosa. I'm like, yeah, can I get a tequila Sprite? And they just all looked at me. I'm like, what? We're all drinking. Like, why y'all judging me for not drinking champagne? It's like, bro, it's like 11 in the morning. I'm like, you're drinking too. Like, just because I'm drinking a man's drink, I'm not drinking no fucking mimosa, I get judged. What about that dude at the bar who's drinking by himself, probably like 3 whiskey cokes in?
Yeah.
Like, yeah, but either way, it's fine, I guess. But yeah, I wanna try Revolver soon.
Revolver's fire shit. I wanna do, they have like, you can pay like $100 to get, what is it? Like a private course meal.
What am I doing that?
Where the chef like does like a, I think it's like maybe 2 entrees, 2 appetizers, a dessert type thing.
I would do it, but my girl's really picky with vegetables. Certain vegetables, like in tacos, is like the onions.
Yeah.
And they're going to put onions in it.
Yeah, they're probably like pretty vegetable heavy.
Yeah, so she's not going to be down with that. She likes her tacos like how they do in Mexico. Tortilla, meat, salsa, that's it. That's all you need.
That's how their like main like tacos are. Like you basically just choose what you want.
Yeah, that's how I know when I go to a Mexican restaurant and get their tacos.
Mm.
That's how I know if it's authentic or not, because authentic tacos don't have lettuce, rarely has cheese.
Yeah,
not the cheese that you know they'll have here, and like you know, you good? Yeah. Okay.
Sorry.
But yeah, that's literally just cilantro, onions, maybe some radish or beets or whatever for you, which one makes the difference.
Yeah.
And then like, you know, a good red sauce, a good green sauce, and that's it. It's all you need.
Yeah. No, Revolver's fire.
I order from Tacos y Mas a lot.
I've gone from there a decent amount. That's a little more fast food, though.
Do a lot of buy one, get one free, though, so I say it's top notch.
Yeah. Buy one, get one free, got me.
I'll shout out Casa Linda Salvadorian Cuisine.
Salvies.
That's my go-to kind of spot right now.
Tres veces mojado.
Get some pupusas.
And you know why we call them tres veces mojado?
No.
It pretty much means 3 times a wetback.
Oh.
Yeah, because they had to cross 3 borders to get to the States.
So I probably shouldn't use that phrase then.
Nah, you shouldn't. I mean, it'll be funny as shit, dude.
I've been eating this place a lot, if you could pronounce
that. Picadera, elevated Dominican street food. Picadera. Yeah, picadera. Which means like, I guess pica just means like to pull and pick at something.
I don't know.
But like, picadera could be a play on words on picadillo, which is just a type of...
it's like a Dominican bodega.
Okay.
Places.
Whatever happened to that one spot you told me, that bodega?
I don't know. They like closed down, I guess.
COVID shut down everything.
They were going for a little bit during COVID. I don't know what
happened. Thank God for Russia.
Oh, thank God. Putin did something right, finally. God
damn it.
They were good, though. Like, they had a bunch of good sandwiches.
Yeah, yeah. To follow their Instagram, they had really good food up, so... Damn, that gave me more hungry now, thinking of talking about food.
Joe T. Garcia's in Fort Worth.
What's it called?
Joe T. Garcia's.
Okay.
You never been there?
Mm-mm.
Oh, it's like 100 years old.
I rarely go to Fort Worth.
Oh, bro, go there for that. You got to take cash, but it's worth it. Their fajitas, like they put all the beans and rice and everything on one skillet.
Oh, okay. I'm gonna look that up. What's it called?
Joe T. Garcia's.
Joe T?
Yeah.
I'm about to look him up, y'all. Let's blow up the spot. Oh, shit. Oh, shit.
Get a picture of margaritas.
Joe T. Garcia's, yeah. Okay. Okay. Let me look at their menu.
It's like just like fajitas.
And oh, yeah. I can tell by the food. Yeah, this is real. This is real authentic. Off the skillet? Damn.
Is it Tex-Mex? Or?
No, this is Mexican.
That's kind of... A little bit, but it looks Mexican. For a minute. It's mostly.
Continue.
It's mostly the Mex. There's a little bit of Tex in there.
Let me see. Chile con queso.
I think best Tex-Mex is El Phoenix.
The OG spot?
Yeah.
I've never had
it's El not Phoenix. The OG, but it's like I think the oldest.
Oldest in Dallas, I know that for sure. It's like the one spot.
Well, I think they sold their like OG location, but the one downtown is still from like the 50s.
Yeah. So. Damn, that's crazy. I never had El Phoenix.
Pretty good.
Not bad.
Yeah, I'm not always there because there's La Taqueria La Ventana right behind it.
Yeah, the little place behind it. Yeah, I love that place.
They have one in the neighborhood too. Yeah. That's really good. It's funny because I've been there on Sunday, I think. And it was me and my girl. We went and then she says, why are all these men coming out like dressed and coming out in really nice cars? I'm like, that's the gay club right there. They're rolling on Molly right now. She's like, it's like 3 p.m. on Sunday.
You haven't noticed the rainbow crosswalk?
Yeah. I'm like, this is like, that's a gay club. She goes, really? I'm like, yeah. And before you say anything, no, I'm not going to that. I'm like, I'm going to be sexually assaulted if I walk in that club. Like, no, like.
I always had that store as a merchandiser for Red Bull.
Really?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember what time we were there. The same time we were there, there's like the 6'5" in heels transgender woman, I guess. Man to woman. And my girl's like, why? Damn, that girl's tall. I'm like, that was a man at one point. And she goes, no. I'm like, can you not tell? Like, look, you want to go talk to her, I guess? It's like, no, I don't want to talk to her. And I'm like, yeah, exactly. Because, man, 6'5" in heels. So he's like 6'9". She's like 6'9", 6'10". Because you got like them big heels. And I'm like, hell no. That's crazy. Let me get another mangonada, please. Yeah, but La Ventana has 3 locations. I've been to all 3. There's 4. I've been all 4. There's one at the Dallas Farmers Market. Mm-hmm. One behind El Phoenix, one in the neighborhood, and then one in Addison.
Mm. Nice.
Yeah. The first one I've been to was the one in Addison. Good food, good drinks.
Yeah. You know? I love the one behind El Phoenix.
Yeah, that's the spot. Especially like when we're waiting for a Mavs game or whatever.
Because everyone usually goes to like El Phoenix.
But. Yeah. I just go to La Ventana. And then because I park in that parking lot. Excuse me. I park in that parking lot and I just walk over to the Mavs game. It's like, what, 2 blocks away, if that. So, damn, now I really want some food. Even though I just had brisket nachos. I'll probably stop and grab me some.
The brisket on those looked fire. The nachos.
It was good.
Aspect looked kind of.
No, it was mid. But I will say that those are the good tortilla chips.
Really?
Like when it comes for nachos, those are the types you want. Like the ones like they come in a big clear bag. It's like extra salty.
Yeah.
They're actually really good chips. It's just, you know, when you get the other chips.
Anytime I see a round nacho chip, I'm kind of skeptical.
No, the round.
I mean round.
Because there was like a circle.
Just a perfect circle.
Yeah, those chips are circles. You didn't see me eating the nachos that were circle chips.
No.
Oh, damn, that's crazy.
I didn't want to look like I was, like, trying to, like, get some of your food.
You could have totally had.
Well, so. I
You said you were getting the brisket nachos, so I was like, what type of brisket do they have here? And then I was like, oh, shit, that looks
good. The sliders look good, too, honestly.
Yeah, the sliders look good. My girl, I wish they told us, the server told us they were small. I'm thinking they're, like fat. She was like, eh, damn, she told me they were small sliders. Nope, medium size. Might as well be a burger.
I might have to run through TiVo when I leave here.
Yeah. You're going to have a run through TiVo tomorrow morning, too.
Cast iron stomach.
Damn, that's crazy. I am not
me. Cast iron.
More of a Taco Bueno fan now.
I like Taco Bueno more.
The one out here is pretty good.
They go too heavy on the beans.
What's wrong with beans?
I like beans. I just don't want it to be all beans.
Yeah, I can eat just beans.
I want to let in a little bit of beans at a time, you know?
You just like... Never mind.
I want to build a wall.
Yeah, I just wanted, like, you know, some kind of barrier between me and the beans, man.
Let's spread them out.
Yeah, we only want good beans.
To Chicago.
Yeah,
to New York.
Good beans only. That's all I like. Oh, man. That's hilarious.
I don't get the joke.
Oh. I can I can explain it. I can totally.
I can't.
Oh, man, that's funny. Oh, man, yeah.
There's a bean crisis at the border. Oh, yeah.
There's a big bean crisis. All kinds of beans. Fucking lima beans. Fucking all kinds of beans. Yeah, man. Black beans, these... pinto beans, all beans. Mm. But we need to get them all out of here. The beans, that is. Damn. Now I really want some beans now.
Well, I think on that note, we should get into the house.
Oh man, I like my beans homegrown. I'm sorry. Saying,
all these beans aren't like refugees, okay?
Come on, guys. Oh man, that's funny. But anyways, Premium Products Podcast. Find us on Instagram at Premium Products Podcast. It's Twitter at @_PPP_. We also have a Reddit, not ours, but, you know, take
some
it over.
Turkish guy made.
r/PPP. We also have.
It's not actually ours, but you can post there.
Yes. And the good old best website ever.
Let that Turkish man know how we're doing.
Yeah. Post whatever on it.
Give him updates. Give him updates about your day.
Yeah.
Some guy's been doing that.
Tell him your opinion on Ukraine. Your real opinion.
Real opinion.
Not just the picture you post on your Facebook profile. Yeah.
Or, you know, tell us how you feel about the the Chinese virus.
The manifest. Yeah, do that.
Yeah, that's funny.
I read those. I'm like, huh, that's nice.
Yeah. Google Translate, my best friend. But we also have the best ever for you to support us on patreon.com/the PPP
on
patreon.com/the PPP. Yes, that's what I thought. Go
bonus
ahead.
Episodes every week. Sometimes we have monthly themed episodes. We do like a movie club.
You can chat with us there.
That's the theme.
Yeah, you can chat with us there. We're gonna have.
We're looking to add more.
Yes, we are.
We could do themes.
So tonight's theme was immigration.
Yeah, get him out of here. God damn it! I'll get beans.
Okay. Oh. I just want to say I disagree.
Not all.
Only the good ones.
Well, keep.
Just side tangent. I watched a deep dive on. I guess not that deep of a dive, but just a rewatch of Ari Shaffir's National Lampoon sketch, "The Amazing Racist."
Yeah, I don't know how that.
Did you ever see that?
I don't know. I haven't seen it.
Oh. That's how like I first saw Ari.
Yeah,
it was like this.
Mine was the stories he did on Comedy Central.
That's yeah, well, like so, like those came out, and I never put together that it was the same.
Right there. Okay, I hold it there.
That it was the same guy.
Okay.
And then, like, somebody pointed it out to me, and they're like, "Yo, yeah, that's like the Amazing Racist guy." And I was like, "Oh shit!" Like, I mean, it makes sense.
Yeah.
Like, fuck.
Yeah.
But it was like a viral like thing that like happened in like 2007.
I might have seen it. I just don't remember.
Apparently, like a lot of them were paid actors, supposedly.
Okay. I would have done it for free. I don't care.
Well, like the one like I
could racism. Remember, you say count me in
and like looked it up. Is he took his to teach like his like nephew responsibility. The like sketch was he took him to buy like a bunch of oranges from this guy selling oranges on the side of the street.
And what race he was?
He was Mexican. And they pulled over and then they walked back and they open the bags of oranges up and start throwing oranges at the dude. That's like, get the fuck out of here. Go back to your country.
Get oranges hurt when you get when they get thrown at you, man. That's the worst part.
Yeah, but they don't leave bruises. That's why you could beat someone with a sack of oranges and get away with it.
I'm sure if you throw, you swing it hard enough.
Those oranges will burst. You swing it too hard.
Let me swing a little. You know what? Never mind. Let me shut up. But we also, it's $1 a month, guys.
Show buck up. A month. Bonus episodes.
You can every also week. Chat with us there as well.
Chat. Discord access.
Yes.
We have gaming servers.
Yes. Eventually going to expand on that.
Yeah.
I think that's all the, am I missing anything?
That's pretty much it.
Yeah. So show love on the Patreon. That's how you show. That's how you get us support.
Hey, chill with that.
Chill with that. Hey, yeah, stop that. But, yeah, because any other way is cool, but, like, no, I need your money. Yeah, like the fucking crackhead that's on down the street that you're going to give money to, fuck that guy. Are you going to support his habit or are you going to support us?
Yeah, we're without the full board today, so we're missing a few hamburgers and whatnot.
Yeah, hamburger. Do we not have the old brother?
No.
Damn.
What about just the good old bleep button?
Nope. That.
No, that bottom middle one could do it for now. Yeah. But yeah, we get into the fit check. I'll go first. I'm wearing the Saucony Shadows original. Got these for Christmas in the all brown and white colorway. I'm wearing just basic cream socks, no brand on them. Levi jeans, and then I was wearing the pink Carhartt. That was my original fit, but I got it dirty with insulation. And now I had to go with the Born and Raised and Force Out to Hate That t-shirt.
Oh, yeah. I will go. I'm in Puma suede with the fat laces.
2024 Puma.
Hidden New York socks. North Face tech pant, just a Hanes blue tee.
Okay, it looks like it's good quality, like thicker than the normal ones.
It's okay.
Okay.
And then a Lacoste gray zip up hoodie.
Oh, I was wearing a black Carhartt jacket hoodie, so
I took it off for the podcast.
Same. It was too hot.
Matt, do you want to do a fit check?
Yeah, man. I'm wearing some Sperry boots. Sort of like mid.
First Sperry on the podcast.
They are?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Some Under Armour socks. They're a little thicker. They stay a
cold
little
outside?
Yeah, it's cold. Chilly. There's below, a big cold front, they say.
It's hitting right now. It's below freezing right now as we speak.
Jack Frost is coming. That's what they say. And then some Levi jeans.
Shout out Levi's.
Yeah. And I got this shirt on underneath my shirt. I don't remember what kind it is, but it's like blue, kind of purple, some pink in there, I think, maybe. And then a green shirt on top of that. It's an athletic material. It's soft as a baby's butt.
Nice.
And
you touching baby's butts? That's crazy.
You never have?
No.
No.
Huh.
No, I'm sorry.
Maybe I need to see someone about that.
Oh, man, my bad.
I don't touch in, like, you know, but, like, you know, not like, like,
you know. You know, you're just making it worse for yourself.
Yeah. You said you had a child Ash shirt. What else?
I had a jacket. There was no, I don't think it's Levi. Do children make Levi stuff?
I don't know.
Levi kids.
I mean, like, do the children make it? One of your squares off. Yeah, I mean, like, do they make the stuff like children?
I'm pretty sure somewhere.
Really?
Yeah, somewhere probably. Oh,
shit.
Yeah. Well, come on, every
I got a child-made jacket as well.
Like a lot of factories, like re-imp or outsource to China.
So my Levi could be a Revi?
Revi Strauss. Yeah. But no, I actually thinking about it, I think Levi's is American. Like, they keep it American. Yeah. Good old.
The whole thing, like, Brett Favre was in the commercial.
Definitely probably made in, like, Malaysia.
No, Brett, you don't think Brett Favre would do that. He didn't clap for Caitlyn Jenner. I don't think he would approve of the children making his stuff.
I don't think he cares about the children. Yeah, showing off his dick and all.
Hey, your dick will look good, a pair of Levi's.
Facts. Nothing but facts. Jesus, man, I'm dying over here. Hey, Don, I'm Moy. Let me see. Let's go ahead and get into our drops of the week. Shit, but
Matt.
Alrighty. Give me 1 second, guys. My iPad decided to not work how I wanted to work. If you want, you can go.
No, that was made by a child.
Yeah, I can tell.
Trying to think which one we left off on.
Ochre. The yellow ochre. Next shoe that's coming out, is the January 16th, the Adidas Samba OG made in Italy. And the black.
We talked about it a little bit last week.
We did?
But yeah.
Okay. Well, if we talked about it last week, just letting y'all know, January 16th.
It's out in a couple days.
$180.
Made in Italy. Black gum Samba.
Next one is the Nike Dunk Low in the Miami Dolphins colorway. January 17th for $115 on Nike.com. Just the Miami Dolphin colors. If you're for our German listeners, it's white cosmic clay dusty cactus. So shout out to our Germans.
Da.
That's Russian, I think.
I'm sure that's
Dusseldorf.
They all say weird stuff.
Yeah. Next one for my golf homies, Air Jordan 1 Low Golf. It's pretty much all white with the gum bottom. January 19th for $150.
Not just a regular gum bottom, a golf traction.
Yes, well, yeah.
Bottom.
That is true. I said
so. It's going to be like a hard plastic.
Yeah.
Not made for indoor wear, made for the golf course.
And if you wear it indoors, you're wild.
You're a dumb fuck.
You're wild. You're wild. Your mama dropped you as a child, and your name is probably Dakota. Next one we have is the Jordan 2 Python on January 20th for $175. It's not a big list today. It's just a high Jordan 2.
I think it's a play on the Nike Air Python.
Yeah. It's a high Jordan 2, the medial and then lateral side, it has a little bit of the Python skin in gray. The midsole,
I'll fuck with these.
Yeah, the midsole is like a cream colorway, and then the OG bottom. These are nice. These are clean. I would not personally get them myself, but they're nice. They're clean. They're,
pretty far.
Yeah. So if you want some Python sneakers, a little bit of accents of Python, get those. What the hell is that? No, he's not. I'm dead. I hope he puts a dick on it. The next one I have is an OG.
No contest.
Yeah. You don't need to know.
It's very funny in the room.
Oh, man. I hope he puts some dumb. I'm going to smack the shit out of it. I hope I see him today or tomorrow so I can smack the shit out of it. Next one is a Nike Air Max Plus in the Voltage Purple. It's finally coming back. Sean McDowell designed this silhouette. Came out in...
Just a side note, there's also a Nike Mercurial Superfly 9 designed to look exactly the same.
Or my foodie buddies, my soccer buddies.
Football. American football.
Oh, is American?
I believe so.
Mercurial, there's only one.
Mercurial is... Yeah, let's be honest, guys.
No, I'm sorry. It is for soccer.
Yeah. Because the Mercurial, I can't say that, is a boot.
But I thought they maybe adapted it.
I mean, they probably, the receivers could probably wear it and the...
It looked like a football.
Okay.
American football cleat. But,
yes, Voltage Purple, $180 on January 20th on Nike.com. For my OG heads, it's a cop. You got a cop.
I heard it's the year of the Air Max Plus.
Oh, you think Nike's dropping a lot of Air Max Pluses?
They have that one with Champs that came out. That's pretty fire.
Yeah. And they don't really have that many coming out for this. That's all that's coming out this week. But what's coming out to keep your eyes on for my women's. I know y'all love this color. The Valentine's Day Dunk Low is coming out.
And then we got the Chinese New Year.
And the Chinese New Year low OGs coming out. The Chinese New Year.
It's a whole pack.
Yeah, is the Year of the Dragon.
Yep.
Yeah, they're coming out with the 38, the two low in women's, and the
I think there's a couple of twos.
Yeah. So you can look forward for those shoes coming up. And within the next week, those are the ones I would say to look out for. Nike always does a Valentine's Day shoe. This year they're going pretty basic with it. Valentine's colorway. Like the red.
I'm usually. Sure more stuff will kind of.
You think they're gonna have another closer. They didn't have a collab last year for the
maybe, I don't know.
They used to do like, you know, they had the Strange Love, Girls Don't Cry.
Yeah. You know, I'm sure there'll be some type of release closer to it.
I will say they did say that they're rumored to to bring back the Verdi's dunk, the Girls Don't Cry, in both colorways. And I always said that was a grill of mine. So
yeah,
for sure, call for me, especially the white pair. I love the red pair, but the white pair is just something I would love to have as well because it was a friends and family.
Things coming in November, February.
I would say,
Nike Air Woven.
You show me that.
Or Air Footscape Woven. Coming back. Fire colorway.
I like them.
They're cool.
I think it's the gray rainbow colorway.
Yeah, my girl likes the cow print ones the more. Of the wovens.
I like the wovens that are, like, do one color and then like have the like different colored woven pattern.
Yeah. I like the concept, but this isn't it for me.
But I'm glad to see that model come back.
Also, I guess we can go ahead and get into some more announcements. Action Bronson has dropped or not dropped, but what is it called when gave a first
teased.
Look teased. The new 1906 R, and this is the Medusa Azul colorway. Mesh runners all year. This started up last year. This year, I feel like they're gonna go more, a lot more.
Yeah.
He also had the rose water that he teased as well. So, action is you will just look into
and
it.
And the Scorpius is the third.
You showed me the Scorpius. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's just kind of a muted version of the rosewater with like greens and yellows.
And if y'all know why Action, if you watch his YouTube, he tells you why he picks these names for his shoes colorways. If y'all don't know, Action was a chef or is a chef, I could say, also a rapper. So a lot of his stuff is named after like foods and stuff like that that have meaning to him or just like colorways that he likes that he comes up with the random name. Medusa Azul is for the Medusa box jellyfish. Cause I think it comes in a blue, the jellyfish is in a blue tint. So pretty cool. Actually, if you go to Queens, there's a all you can eat Chinese buffet that's really good. That, has jellyfish on the menu. Heard the consensus is ass, but just like having like jelly or something.
I heard that's what I think that's the one that Will Smith like killed himself with in that movie 7 Pounds.
I have not seen.
Yeah, well, he had like a giant like man of war.
It was a big jellyfish.
Yeah.
Yeah. Gave him a heart attack.
Yeah, some of them are poisonous. Not all of them, though.
They're in a bathtub with them.
It's only like one specific one that will like kill you.
Fucked up movie.
The Portuguese man of war.
Yeah, the man of wars are the crazy ones.
Yeah.
But
all his organs.
Yeah, the jellyfish doesn't have their stingers. It's just the top.
Yeah.
So it's safe to eat, which I don't know why they would eat that, but.
I think there's some places around here that
have. Yeah, he like makes fun of that blind guy.
Who doesn't make fun of people with disabilities?
Come on.
Especially people who fake having a disability. Those are the best.
You know anyone who's done that? Oh.
I don't. Come on, man. We talked about that. Sorry. Wah, 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 wah. God damn it.
Palace founder leave Tanjun is.
Oh, yeah. I saw this. Going to Fila. Yeah, Fila. You think Fila is going to make a comeback this year?
Probably.
I know they're big in the Europe area.
Yeah. They had like a model that was kind of like an Air Force that they did with Gosha. Me and Josh both have pairs that I kind of fuck with. Like that, like when you get like a premium leather one, it's pretty nice. I think they're right here in the closet.
Oh, we're about to have my first look on these. While he looks into that, I was going to talk about the new release of the, let me find it. The Bode Nike Astro Grabber is coming out fall 2024. This shoe looks really nice. It looks like if you look at it, you'll think it's a track cleat. Let me show you. Let me see if I can pull up better pictures than what I have. I think Colin actually sent me this on Instagram, so I can pull it up quicker. Oh yeah. Okay, I remember these. Yeah. The hood kids in the hood wore those all the time.
The T1.
Yeah, like those were the ones that you seen, like, if you see a kid wearing that, like, bro, he look crazy.
Name one of the hood kids from the hood.
Oscar. Mario was crazy. Him, he was cousins with Oscar, and then the homie Nazario.
But this is, like, a real premium, like, leather.
Yeah, I can tell by here. It looks really, really good.
With, like, a nice, like, suede, too.
Yeah. Let me see if you get
the Fila tracksuit. I hated the Disruptor because I feel like that's what kind of killed Fila, like, from having any type of moment. Because I feel like they have enough models where they could kind of have like a little mini, like resurgence kind of thing.
Or the Nike one.
Hey, get out of here.
And then let me see if I get a better up close. Nope, no up close. That's cool. Awesome.
Yeah, I had to order new those foam pads.
But yeah, Fila's like, I'll keep an eye out for Fila because if y'all don't know Palace has always had really good drops, really good clothes.
They have like the models. They have the Grant Hill Filas. Those are really. I would imagine we'll get some type of version of that.
Yeah. Okay. See, I had one more. Fuck! Oh shit! Why did I lock it? Where is it? By the way, guys, if y'all have anything sneaker related that you want to send to us, that's fine. You can send it through the Patreon. That's how we'll guarantee see it. So send it to the Patreon.
Yeah, let me give you Colin's address.
No.
Do not. We are not doxing.
Rate and review the podcast.
Yes. Shit. Oh, my God. Why isn't this shit working, man? You know what? Fuck myself. Just go ahead and fuck myself. There was another one that we were talking about the other day. There it is. The A6 CP company collab is dropping with the Gel Quantum 368.
Yes.
It comes in a solid yellow and then also a, like a muted gray and black outsole. Which one did you say you would liked?
I like the, isn't there like a yellow one?
That's what I say, the all yellow one. Yeah. I like that one too. I honestly thought you would have picked the other one because I've seen, never seen you wearing like yellow sneakers. The only thing close to yellow would be the slippers you have.
Yeah, I got a couple of yellow shoes.
Like that are like predominantly yellow or just?
Yeah.
Like, okay. I didn't know that. My bad. Here you go. I don't think I have any yellow. Do I have any yellow sneakers? No, I don't. Damn. Looks like I gotta go cop some banana yellow sneakers.
I have no yellow shoes either.
Yeah. Well, because the yellow shoes I like the most only come in women's shoes. Like, and then they sold out and then they don't make my size. It's the New Balance and Ghani collab.
Yeah.
That's the my favorite like sneaker, yellow sneaker ever that I've seen.
Do they make it in like the woman's size?
It's in the women's, but they only go up to a women's, I think, 13 or 12. I'm a woman's 14 and a half. Yeah. So they did not make it in my size. So unfortunately, that happens a lot when I look at really cool women's sneakers.
I have like a pair of Nike. I don't know what they are, but it's like a collab with this brand, Polar. I don't think they're 5.0s, but it's like a that type of era of Nike SB.
Yeah.
Where it's like a ACG shoe that I can't see anybody really skateboarding in. But,
Yeah, I seen a homie skateboard in cowboy boots. Like, that's crazy to me. But I know what you mean, though. It's just a random thought.
But they're like mustard yellow.
Okay.
And then they're more white, but I have the Reebok pumps, and they're pretty.
Okay.
Like neon yellow.
Okay.
But I just don't know.
I'm trying to think. The most yellow I have is those J Balvin's, but it's only a hint of yellow.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking, no. I'm good. Another one I have that I just remembered is the, Leo Messi gets his own Samba. It's coming out soon. Yeah. Very simple Samba. Oh, yeah. I forgot about that.
I was booing the Samba.
Yeah. The Samba is very, like...
Fuck Messi.
Yeah. No, I fuck with Messi. That's my dude.
Messi fuck Messi.
Messi all the way. He's the greatest ever.
Fuck soccer.
He goes, fuck that European sissy shit.
I'm Dallas till I die. Fuck Messi. Unless he comes to...
Unless he's become a... Miami. No, they're... What's FC Dallas's like?
Was it animal? A Mustang?
Yeah, it's a Mustang.
Yeah, okay. I forgot.
But still mascot.
From when they used to be Burn.
Burn?
They used to be the Dallas Burn.
Oh, okay.
Now they're FC Dallas.
Yeah. They're a treat.
But it was like a flaming Mustang.
Caca.
Was it over in the neighborhood?
No. No, it was actually a cool Mustang that was just on fire.
Oh, okay. On fire.
Yeah, man. Come on. Not no sissy Mustang. What was I saying before? Sherman's Texoma FC just random thing about
soccer. Yeah, I saw that.
They're going to have their own indoor soccer game for like a...
Yeah, some type of big league or some shit like
no, that. No, it's its own league, but they're having a drive for like clothes for kids for indoor soccer and soccer stuff, like donating soccer stuff.
Yeah.
And they're going to have a game, like an indoor game. Like a little showcase. So, just interesting. Just thought y'all would maybe be interested in that back home local news. But I'm more interested about the baseball team that's coming in.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the Shadow Cats.
Is it some type of minor league team?
Yeah, Sherman's having their own minor league
team. Oh, my God.
They're actually going to be they're going to renovate Veterans Field, and they just got their license to sell alcohol there.
Talk about undeserving pieces of shit.
Hey, there's always been a decent bit of like baseball talent that comes out of Sherman.
I mean, yeah.
Yeah, but I don't think the city has the population or the care.
It will in the next few years.
Probably why.
Yeah, it's going like crazy.
I don't know what's the current population. I know it's in over the 40s.
Like, it's
around 50,000.
Los su puta madre esto.
But yeah, it's around 50 right now, but they're projecting like 100,000 over the next 10 years.
I feel like they've been saying that for like 10 years.
But yeah, but now there's a lot of industry coming there right now. Now they're building a lot of houses.
Yeah, that's kind of living there, man. Yeah, the houses are being built by the sewage plant, just letting y'all know. So those nice houses and the water park that they're about to build there.
Yeah.
It's fresh. Fresh doo-doo.
The pee-pee.
Yes, fresh doo-doo water. But they're going to have bars there too, so I might go. I might
pop. Just don't get ice in your drink and
you're fine. Yeah, you Gucci.
Yeah, and just don't worry about what they're using to wash your cup with.
You know what? Nah, I'm not going to
wash your what?
Cup with.
Oh, well, it's got alcohol in it to clean that.
I'll just buy bottled beer.
I'm sure it's clean.
Bottled beer the whole time I'm there.
Look, man, we're dipping and dodging all these coronaviruses. Who cares about a little pee-pee water, you know?
Yeah. And I'm like, you know, because I have a coworker that lives there. And I'm like, does the wind ever blow? And it's that direction. He's like, yeah, sometimes you smell it. And I'm just like, yeah, nah, bro. Nah. You're going to have an HOA next to the poop.
Nope.
Boy. Yeah, so.
It is going to start hallucinating. A
bunch of methane gas is coming out.
Well, folks, we are going to switch over to the Patreon.
Oh, just real quick, Beans Paper Girl Paris has an A6 GT 2160. Look into it. It comes out soon. Paper Girl Paris is the women's division of Paperboy. So look into it. It's pretty nice. I like it a lot. I will definitely try to cop if they have my size. Comes out the 19th. It actually came out today on Beams Harajuku, but I don't.
Good luck getting that shit.
Yeah, I actually grabbed stuff from France before, so
You've been eating snails too?
No, but I had frog.
We'll continue this over on the Patreon.
Bye, guys.